You're welcome to Open Heaven's Devotional Commentary, a guide to a close fellowship with God. I'm Salam Manager Haruna, your host. We are glad to have you. Hello, good morning. Thank you for joining us today again. Open Heaven is written by our Father and the Lord, Pastor E.E. Adeboye, General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. And this commentary is intended to bring insight to God's Word by the help of the Holy Spirit. Today's date is Wednesday, the 17th day of March 2021, and our topic for today is Tomorrow May Be Too Late. Let us pray. Dear God, our Father in heaven, we love you, we worship you. We are happy that we can come before you one more time in sound health to learn of you. We ask, O God, that there will be an entrance of your word. Let it find place in our hearts and let it be a transformation within. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord. You're welcome back. Our memory verse for today is from the book of Matthew chapter 3 verse 2. Matthew 3 verse 2 reads, "And saying, Repent ye, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand." Matthew 3 verse 2. Our Bible reading is from the book of Acts chapter 5 from verse 1 to 10. Acts 5 verse 1 to 10 reads, "But a certain man named Ananias, with Sapphira his wife, sold a possession and kept part of the price, his wife also being privy to it, and brought a certain part, and laid it at the apostles' feet. But Peter said, Ananias, why hath Satan filled thine heart to lie to the Holy Ghost, and to keep back part of the price of the land? While it remained, was it not thine own? And after it was sold, was it not in thine own power? Why hast thou conceived this thing in thine heart? Thou hast not lied unto men, but unto God. And Ananias, hearing these words, fell down, and gave up the ghost. And great fear came on all them that heard these things. And the young men arose, wound him up, and carried him out, and buried him. And it was about the space of 3 hours after, when his wife, not knowing what was done, came in. And Peter answered unto her, Tell me whether ye sold the land for so much. And she said, Yea, for so much. Then Peter said unto her, How is it that ye have agreed together to tempt the Spirit of the Lord? Behold, the feet of them which have buried thy husband are at the door, and shall carry thee out. Then fell she down straightway at his feet, and yielded up the ghost. And the young men came in, and found her dead, and carrying her forth, buried her by her husband. God bless his word in Jesus' name. Amen. Our Father in the Lord says in today's devotional that when people hear the topic of today, they feel the preacher is only trying to manipulate them into surrendering their lives to Christ immediately. There is no need for a preacher to manipulate you. If he says tomorrow may be too late, he knows what he is saying. I have seen many times where a fellow did not get the chance to repent before he or she died and went to face judgment in heaven. They refused to repent when they had the chance until it became too late. There was a chief I had been preaching to for years who kept saying he would repent but not yet. One day, he suddenly had a stroke but managed to tell his people to send for me. I went, prayed for him, and God healed him. Then I said, Chief, I sense that God only gave you a second chance. Will you give your life to him now? He said, not yet. The next time I heard about him, he was dead. There was another man who was sick and at the point of death. I went to pray for him, but each time I came to the hospital, somehow I was unable to see him. I kept trying to see him for about 2 days but couldn't. At last, when it seemed like I would be able to see him the next day, I arrived at the hospital and learned that he had died. If only I had gotten the chance to see him, I would have asked him to give his life to Christ first, before praying for him. If he had died then, at least I would have known that he went to heaven. There was another man, a pastor, someone people looked up to as a great man of God. I got the report that he was committing sexual immorality with girls, and he denied it. So I set up a committee to investigate. In the meantime, I put the pastor on suspension. The people investigating brought evidence to prove that he was guilty of the allegations against him. The plan was to walk him through a process of repentance, but while the investigation was ongoing, he died in a car accident. Beloved, it may seem as if there will always be time to repent and start living holy, but tomorrow really may be too late. Everyone has a cup. The day that cup gets full is the day the fellow's time to repent runs out. In your own interest, drop that sin and begin to live holy from today. A word is enough for the wise. God bless his word to us today in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise God. Here we are again before God with this soul-searching topic. 1 Timothy chapter 2 verse 3 and 4 tells us, "For this is good and acceptable in the sight of God our Savior, who will have all men to be saved and to come unto the knowledge of the truth." It is very important to state clearly that God is not desirous that anyone should perish. But as much as he is a God of love, he is also a God of justice. Our Father in the Lord says that many people will hear today's topic and believe that the preacher may just be trying to just talk them into salvation and giving their lives to Christ. There is truly no need to manipulate anyone. The truth is, we have only now, this moment, to make our ways right with God. You cannot be so sure about the next moment. That is why with every opportunity that you have, you do an inward search. That is why you must be sure that in the day you hear his voice, you do not harden your heart or procrastinate because you believe that you still have plenty of time. If we must tell ourselves the truth, you can do a rethink and remember people who are not even as old as you are, who are no longer here. You can also think of those who are older than yourself, who have gone. That should tell you that you are not too young, neither are you too old to follow that same way. His grace has kept us, and we must see every moment that we have as the day of salvation, as his mercy reaching out to us to enable us to make our ways right with him. Our Father in the Lord in today's devotional has given us a series of examples. Men who had close shave with giving their lives to Christ before death. Please do not be added to that list of people who would ignore Christ even up to the last moment. In our Bible reading today, we saw the story of Ananias and Sapphira. These two never imagined that they would lose their lives the same day, the way they did. It came suddenly. We must ask ourselves also that if we are visited suddenly, where would we make it to? May God help us in Jesus' name. Hebrews 9 verse 27 tells us, "And it is appointed unto men once to die, but after this, the judgment. Once a man dies, the gate of mercy is closed over him. There is no altering of the details of his life anymore. His destination is certain." For some of us, the pleasures of this world have still blinded our eyes, making us feel that all is well. We have the best of things, so we believe there is no need for God. But even the scripture warns such people. It says in 1 Corinthians 15 verse 19 that if in this life only we have hope in Christ, we are of all men most miserable. May that never be our portion in the name of Jesus. We'd bow our heads now, and if you know within your heart of hearts that you need the Lord Jesus, please do not let today pass you by. Just open your mouth and say after me, say, "Lord Jesus, I surrender to you today. I believe that you died for me and that you arose again. I receive you today into my life. Come and rule. Come and be my Lord and Savior. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen." For the rest of us, would ask for grace to finish strong. Ask him to enable us that we would not fall by the wayside. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Heavenly Father, we bless your name today. Thank you for loving us so much. Father, help us to always live with your consciousness. And when you would return, O Lord, please help us not to be caught on our ways. Let us be ready to meet with you. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord. We have a key point today that tells us tomorrow may be too late. Amen. Please do not procrastinate when Jesus is calling. Hallelujah. Thank you for joining us today. We are glad that you did. If you'd like to speak to someone or to receive an update like this daily, please send a WhatsApp or Telegram message to +234 080-986-11226. Do well also to bless someone today with this by sharing it with them. Remain steadfast in the way of the Lord in Jesus' name. Amen. Bye for now.
I believe you enjoyed today's devotional. We'd love to hear from you. Kindly leave a comment. You can connect with us on any of our social media handles attached. God bless you. Have a great day and see you tomorrow.